Hello and welcome to Cimbrer Bushcraft. And today I have received a package in the mail from this company, Lamnia. It is from Finland, from Helsinki. And it's something I have ordered for a couple of days ago. And now I'm going to show you what it is. So hang on. Let's see what's inside. This firm in Finland, Lamnia, is a big company that sells a whole lot of stuff to bushcraft and outdoor people. They have a lot of knives. I can only recommend them. And they have a quick service for delivery. Ah, so now you'll see. Look at this. It's a Tomahawk from CRKT, and it's made of carbon steel. The name is Woods Nobo Tomahawk, and one of the reasons why I bought this is because I have some plan with it. I would like to customize it. First of all, I have to cut this off. Yeah. It's sharp, not razor sharp. Yeah, and now I have removed the head from the handle, and I can see that there's some varnish on the heads and, of course, on the handle. So that I'm going to remove. And to that I'll use this product. I used this before in a video where I stripped my SE5 knife. So I'll apply this, and then after that I will burn this with a torch to make it look old school. I just apply this and let it work for a while, and then the varnish I can just scrape it off. Perhaps I am going to apply this more than once. It's depending on how good this varnish is. Set for a while and putting some on the head. And my plan is to afterwards applying gun black on this head too, like I did with my knife. I forgot the gloves. Put on a thick layer. Let it soak in. When I'm finished with this, I'll wash it in water to get the rest off, and then I'll use sandpaper to make the finish. And now I'm going to try to take this fine layer of varnisher. Coating on, off. It's not as easy as with the knife and the black paint, but it's only a matter of patience and time. So I just have to do this a couple of times, then I'm sure it will be nice and clean. Now the head has been cleaned. completely, and I put on some tape because I don't want the edge to be black. So then I'll take this product. It's Brunerung, it's called, it's Deutsch, German, we call it Dun Black. And what this does is it makes the metal turn black. I just take this. And as you can see, immediately the metal is going to be black. And after I've done this, I have to wash it off with cold water. Well, now I'm finished with the gun black. And as you can see, the surface is not glossy, it's matte black. And the edge is not black. You can see it, but I used a file to make some markings in this. It's to make it look a little bit old. I think it looks cool. And I also cleaned up the handle, the hickory handle. And now I'm going to burn it with my torch out in my workshop. That I won't do in here. You have to be careful when you do this, because suddenly it gets very burnt. So small step at a time. And I want it to be even, the burning. Then I'll use sandpaper on it. Just a little bit. As you can see, I don't know where, there. It's a little bit darker, but I think they call it the ores in the wood has become much clearer. And when I'm using linseed oil at the end, it will be more brown. But the trick here is not to overdo it, not to keep on burning. You have to stop in time, because otherwise it will be too much, I think. So now I'm finished with the tomahawk. And you can see how it looks. I put some oil on the head, and that makes it a little bit glossy, but also more even. And the handle I have burned with a torch, as you saw. And it has, I have put some linseed oil on it. So perhaps I'll make a color for this, perhaps some sort of leather handle, I don't know yet. But I made a sheet for it, this little sheet you can see, made of leather, and it fits nicely. And perhaps some of you may have noticed I've shortened the handle too. And the reason for that, one of the reasons why I bought the tomahawk and customized it, I'll show you here. You see my rucksack from Frost River? After a while, it sort of collapsed a little bit in the front, because I don't have any frame here. So my wish was to make it stand up more straight, and so that these pockets doesn't have contact with the ground. So that's why this tomahawk is very useful here. And I'll tell you why. I just show you from this angle, it down here, and it lifts up here. Yeah, like that. And here you can see, if I put the tomahawk down here, lift this up, I'm going to get what I want. So, the solution for the problem is, let's take this. I made this out of leather and a little D-ring in brass. So I sawed this on, this little bag without a bottom in that can fit an axe. In order to make the axe stay in place and lift the rucksack at the front, I made such one. It fits on top of the axe, and there's a little antler here I made, and I'll show you why. I bring it down here, and then I just lift it up like this. And then you can see, if you see it from the side, the rucksack is completely straight, and these pockets don't touch the ground. So I think it's awesome. And when I'm lifting the rucksack and to take it on my back, this just happened. Goes a little bit further down, but when I stand it on the ground again, it stays in place. But I doesn't have to take this out of the D-ring every time. I just lift this a little bit and pop this off, so I can take the axe or the tomahawk up. If I had the anchor points on the top of the head, there was a risk that the head would get loose and fall down. I hope you understand that. I think it was an okay solution, and I think it's gonna work. And besides using the tomahawk to do this with my rucksack, I also want to use it to split wood. And actually, I would like to learn to throw a tomahawk. This was all for now, folks. I hope you enjoyed the video and the demonstration of how I customize this tomahawk and use it as a part of my rucksack system. And I hope you could find inspiration in some of these details I made. And I hope to see you on the next one. Take care. Bye-bye.